Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sibelius and landandairphotos.com. Today I'm going to walk you through the setup of the DJI Mavic Air 2. This video is part of a series of episodes on the Mavic Air 2. Follow the link in the upper right corner to learn more about the Mavic Air 2. If you want to purchase a Mavic Air 2, follow the link in the description below and get it direct from DJI. Now, on with this episode. Setting up drones used to be a rather complicated task, but DJI has made setup for the Mavic Air 2 very easy. I'm going to walk you through the steps to get your drone assembled, activated, updated, and ready to fly. Your first step to setting up your Mavic Air 2 is to take everything out of the box and check it with the shipping list or the packaging information on the box and make sure you got everything that was supposed to be included. You have two options, the basic package and the Fly More combo. As you can see here, the Fly More combo includes two additional batteries, a bag, filters, and other extras. Just make sure that you got everything you were supposed to get. If you purchase the Fly More combo, make sure you look in the top pocket of the case here, because that's where I found the cables, the RC cables that connect the phone to the remote controller. First thing we're going to do is charge the battery so we can do the firmware updates that are necessary to get this aircraft set up. To test the power on your battery, you simply press the power button once. As you can see, there is one light on and one light blinking here, and that means that the power is between 25% and 50%. You want to do your firmware update and your setup, your activation, with a full battery on the battery and on the controller to make sure you've got plenty of power for the whole process. To do that, we're going to remove it from the aircraft here. There are buttons on either side of the battery, and you simply pinch in and squeeze them and lift up, and the battery comes right off. To charge your battery, take the battery plug that's attached to your battery charging unit and plug it directly into the battery. When it's in, you'll see the lights are now blinking on the battery to indicate that it's charging. If you bought the Fly More combo, it came with this flat piece here. This is a battery charging hub that allows you to charge multiple batteries at one time. To use it, take the piece here and plug it in. This is the cable from the battery charger, and now it plugs into this unit. You can see the green light is lit. Now we simply plug in the batteries. You can see the lights activated there. Plug that in, the lights lit up. It in, and now all three batteries are charging. It will determine which one to charge first and get them all charged up. It does it sequentially. It doesn't actually charge them all at one time. It charges them one at a time. While we're at it, we need to make sure that we've got plenty of charge on the controller as well. To test your battery charge, you press the power button once, same as the battery. And here you can see that it's got three solid lights and one is blinking, which means it's between 75 and 100% charge. Well, we want it fully charged. So, take the cable that came with the drone, and plug it into the charger unit, and then plug it into the base here. And you can see the lights are blinking, and that indicates that the battery is charging. While the batteries are charging, we can go ahead and install the app on your smart device and set up an account with DJI if you don't already have one. And to do that, you open up the Play Store on an Android device or the iTunes Store or whatever it's called on Apple devices and search for the app. We will search for DJI Fly. There it is.
Now, I obviously already have it installed, but you just click, there'll be an install button, you click on it and it will install it on your smart device. Basically the same process for the Apple products. Now, go to DJI.com and set up an account there if you don't already have one. You'll need a DJI account to activate your drone. You can create the account through the DJI Fly app, but I think it's easier just to do it from your computer.
You look at the drone, you see that you've got stickers on the aircraft that you need to remove. Now we're going to go through the setup of the remote controller. This is actually pretty simple to do. First thing you do is connect your sticks. The sticks are stored in little slots down here on the bottom. Pull them out. And then they screw into the holes on the front of the controller. Now, the cable that connects the controller to your smart device, your phone or your tablet or whatever you're using, is hidden beneath this piece here, which is what holds the smart device in place. So if you lift it up, you'll see the cable is directly underneath. The drone ships with a cable for the iPhone. I use an Android, so I had to switch it out. And if you have to switch yours out, you can simply pull out the plug from there, and you'll see a little port down there. To put it away, take out the port, the plug that you need, line it up, and snap it right into place. To attach the smart device, you line it up with the plug-in port to the right, because that's the side where the cable is. Lift up the device holder and slide it into place. See, there's two little notches here at the bottom that holds the phone in place along with up at the top. You can see it's not going anywhere. Now the smart device connected, take the plug and insert it, and the controller is all set up and ready to go.
Let's get the drone ready. If you haven't already, unfold the arms of the drone. I have my props on in this video because I shot it after setting my drone up, but you should probably do your setup without the props installed as a good safety practice. Once the drone is unfolded, insert a fully charged battery into the drone if you haven't done it already.
I'm going to start with this. Controller is charged. The DJI Fly app is installed. So all I'm going to do is start this with the power button. I'm going to press it and then press it and hold. And it opens up the app automatically. Let's set this aside for a minute. Now let's talk about the drone. I haven't got the propellers installed yet. I do have a full battery on there, but I don't need the propellers because all I'm doing is setting this thing up. Now before I do that, I want to take this gimbal guard off before I do anything else. So I take that off. And so now we got little pads on here that we can get rid of. Not that they'll do anything, but we can get rid of those. So the aircraft is ready to power up. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to press and press and hold. Now we'll wait and see and make sure that the drone connects to the controller.
I'm getting a activate message, so I agree. Now I'm already logged in on this Play app, so it shouldn't have any kind of problem. Just confirming to bind, activate, restart to complete the aircraft. So press stop, shut it down. It says that it'll take about 30 seconds. Aircraft is now activated. Done. It's offering me the chance to get DJI Care Refresh. I'm not going to do that. Okay, it's telling me that I need to update my firmware for the drone. So I hit update. The firmware update will take several minutes. This is why you need a fully charged battery and controller for the setup. During the firmware process, the lights on the drone will blink, the equipment will beep, and the aircraft may even reboot. This is normal. Cool, firmware is installed. Close that. And now you can see we are set up. Shows that the firmware is installed. Shows that we have the Mavic Air 2 set up. Hit go fly. And now you're looking right through the camera screen. If you have more than one battery, you need to update the firmware for each battery. You might as well do this now so you don't get the firmware update message when you're out in the field. Power up the controller. Replace the battery in your drone with the next battery, then power up the drone. When the DJI Fly app opens, you should see a message that the battery requires a firmware update. Tap the update link. The screen message tells you it's updating the battery firmware. When finished, the message will tell you the firmware has been installed. Power down the drone and then the controller. Repeat this process for all of your batteries. Another update that may be required is the FlySafe update. This is the data behind DJI's no-fly zone functions. If you see this message, just tap Update on the screen, then tap the Update button and the FlySafe data will update. When finished, the screen will tell you that FlySafe data has been updated. Finally, let me show you how to attach the propellers. In recent years, DJI has built their props so you couldn't put the prop on the wrong motor. Unfortunately, the Mavic Air 2 allows you to put the wrong prop on a motor. This is why you see all kinds of stickers on the drone to identify which motors are which. This is why the Fly app will remind you to make sure you have your props on correctly before you launch. If you put the props on incorrectly, the drone will crash as soon as you try to take off. Fortunately, it's very easy to match up the props and the motors. Two of the motors have a silver marking on them. Two of the propellers have the silver ring around the hole for the propeller shaft. Silver-marked props go on silver-marked motors. The remaining props and motors are all black, and those go together. Here's how to attach a propeller.
Here's the black propeller and the black motor pod. Put it on the hole and I'm going to turn the motor. Push down and turn the motor. And now the motor's on there properly, or the propeller's on there properly. Next one is a silver. As you can see, this has the silver ring. Matches up with the silver markings on the motor. I'm going to push this on and turn the motor. that's on. Try it again with the black. Here's the black. Black motor. Push this on. And turn the motor. Last one, silver and silver. Push it on. And that's all there is to it.
We're all set up. Before you fly, you need to insert a media card unless you want to store your recordings in the internal memory. You will also probably need to calibrate your drone before your first flight or after any firmware updates. I'll cover those tasks and many other things you need to know in future tutorials on the Mavic Air 2. If you want to buy the Mavic Air 2, follow the link in the description below and get it straight from DJI. On screen now, you'll see a playlist for more videos on the Mavic Air 2, so be sure to check them out. Before you go, leave a comment, I do try to respond, and be sure to hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon so you'll be notified when I publish again. Thanks for watching.